We live in the clean, safe city of Glendale in the United States, about 30 minutes away from Los Angeles where many Koreans live. With over 100 years of history in the United States, Koreans have left multiple traces of their traditional culture throughout the country, one of them being the Comfort Woman statue located in Central Park near the Glendale Public Library in California. This statue was built with great difficulty in 2013 by the Korean American Forum of California, which was first founded overseas. The Comfort Woman statue has been around for about 7 years, standing next to the large library that many people often visit. Despite this, whenever we go to the library, most of us just pass by the statue, not even glancing at it. With the lack of care and management provided for this meaningful statue, it has been a target of constant damage from those who do not understand its importance.
Comfort Woman Day was created to commemorate the Korean women who were forced against their will into sexual slavery by the Japanese Army during World War II. This is a day to remember the harsh and painful abuse the Korean women had faced on a day-to-day basis. Few examples included being raped for hours at a time and being severely starved, often leading to deaths. Thus, Comfort Woman statue, also known as the Statue of Peace, was erected in order to serve as a call for apology and remembrance. Sitting next to an empty chair, a young girl with roughly cut hair tightly clasped her two hands. She wears no shoes and her heels are uncomfortably lifted off the ground. A small bird sits on her left shoulder and a white butterfly flies behind her chair. While looking at the statue of a girl whose shadow is of a grandmother, our hearts were heavy as we thought of the pain they had suffered when they were our age.
As we Korean Americans are born and raised in America, we often forget our identity as Koreans. Even when we heard the news regarding the Japanese government's intention to get rid of the statue, we were not interested since we thought that it was something we didn't have to worry about. Many of us even have Japanese friends who are also second-generation immigrants. However, we did not care for this topic to the point where we would argue over these issues like our parents would.
This all changed when we attended the opening ceremony of the Guardians event as a member of our nonprofit organization. There, we learned that many Koreans wanted to preserve the Statue of Peace as it contains important historical lessons. A large inauguration ceremony about the Protection of Peace Monument was held with many various American and Korean American organizations in order to protect this statue. Little by little, we became interested in learning about the history behind Comfort Woman Day and the Comfort Woman statue and wanted to take lead in doing something meaningful. We decided to go to the statue once a month early in the morning to help keep it clean as a part of a team composed of local students with the same goal, to restore honor in remembering the Comfort Woman who suffered for years.
Every month when we return to clean the statue, we are relieved to see that it is still clean. As we continued our volunteer work, we noticed that in the same places that we had originally found broken beer bottles, we found flower pots that people had left. Through this, we realized the importance of our work and that even the simplest task of cleaning can help make a difference. As we continued to clean the surroundings of the statue and water the flower pots left by the others, our tiredness from hours of cleaning washed away and we felt rewarded.
Although the statue was originally only meant to be a symbol of remembrance for Comfort Woman, it has now become a symbol of peace around the world. When people see this statue standing proudly in the park, undamaged and clean, we hope that they know that diverse cultures are welcomed, and for this reason, we still help clean the statue even in the midst of COVID-19.
During our monthly visits, we continue to learn more about the tragic events that happened during World War II. As we move forward in our lives, we will always remember our identities as Korean Americans and will forever remember the sufferings these women had to endure.